Hello! Welcome to Little Smiles Kindergarten 1 online tutorials. Today's tutorial is on numeracy. Numeracy. Taking from strand 6. All around us, sub-strand 1. Living and non-living things. Indicator 5. Identify and describe objects by color and size. Identify and describe objects by color and size. Now, kids, we are going to describe objects using their sizes or length or height, which falls under measurements. Now, these are the words that we are going to use in describing objects. The key words are big, small, tall, short, long. Let's go over again. Big, small, tall, short, long. Now, let's look at the key words again. What do we mean by the word big? Big is something very wide. Something very wide. In the other way around, small is very tiny or little. Very small. Let's look at the word tall. Tall is mostly used for living things. Some objects also use tall. When something is standing upright, for example, when this stick is standing upright, when this plant is standing upright, we use the word tall. Let's look at the word short. Short is the opposite of tall. This stick is tall. This is also a stick standing upright, but comparing to this one is what? Short. Let's compare these two plants standing. This plant is tall. This plant is short. Because they are standing upright, we use tall. And we use short. Now, let's look at long. Some people use long instead of tall. No. Let's look at the difference. When something is lying down, we use long. Let's look at the difference. This stick is standing upright, so we use tall. But as soon as it lies down, we use long. So when we are comparing these two sticks, because this stick is lying down, this stick is long, this stick is short. So note the difference between long and tall. When it is standing upright, we use tall. we use tub. So children, note the difference between long and short. Let's move to the board. Today we are going to compare objects using big, small, tall, short, and long. Let's look at big and small. This book is big, this book is small. When you compare the two, this book is big, this book is small. Let's look at example A. Let's look at object A and object B. Which one is big? Which one is small? A is big. B is small. Good. We are going to compare these two trees. Tree C and tree D. Because they are standing upright, we are going to make use of tall and short because they are standing upright. So let's compare C and D. C is tall. D is short because they are standing upright. Now, let's compare E and F. We are comparing the surfaces. E is small. F is big. Let's compare G and H. These two chocolate bars. G is lying down, H is also lying down. So what are we going to use? Are we going to make use of long or tall? I told you before that when an object is lying down, we use long instead of tall. So G is tall. G is long, H is short. Good. G is long because it is lying down. H is short. Now let's compare these two flowers. K is small. L is big. So kids, note the difference between long and short. As I said, when two objects are standing upright, we compare using tall and short. When two objects are lying flat, we compare using long and short. Finish today's tutorials, I will download this exercise. Download and answer the question. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, and our next tutorial will be in 4 days' time. Bye-bye.